It look a little different here. Had to take my copper stuff in. Cindy's got a bad toothache. I had to take her in to take and get medicine and see a dentist about getting it pulled later on. So I took my copper number one, copper two in, tubing, and three CLR, or what it called, copper aluminum radiators. I ended up taking all that in for $181.40, and it just barely paid for her medicine and the one little doctor's visit. So, got a bunch more today from my guy that I'm going to work on today. All this stuff to take apart, plus a pile up front. I don't know if I can. Pile up front's too far away to take and see. But I'm going to start taking some of this apart. Get it ready. That's got to be chopped up. Got to cut these pieces off to get the good off. Get the stuff to solder put back. I've never cleaned one of these quick connect pieces that I got today. But I'm going to try. See if I can get the plastic to come out of them. Never done it before, but let's see what happens. And it's got stuff down inside of it as well. So it'll probably have to be cut up or something, because it's got plastic in it and everything else. Like I said, I've never cleaned one up before. It's something I've got to work on later on, I guess. Oh, channel locks. See if I can get some of this apart. This piece still has part of a hose from a water heater stuck on it. I think it's from a washing machine. A little screw brass. Yes, it is. What did I do with my brass container? Let's get those in it. Start a new brass container because I took all the other in. So, turn this a little bit. Put this behind there a little bit. We're going to need it bright on you guys. See if I can start taking some of this stuff apart. We're going to get the brick out here in a few minutes. Chop up some more copper. Come on. Come on, there. There it goes. That's aluminum. Pewter. Wait, put that in the vise. Another piece goes in the bucket over here. Copper to be hand cut down. I ain't got the money to buy a stripping machine, so I have to sit and cut it all down by hand. And Cindy helps. Thank you. on, Luce. Come on. Well, I guess I'm just going to have to... There we go. Another piece of aluminum. Just have to get rough with it. Move my drill down. Yeah, it's still chilly in here, but it's not as bad as it has been. Not really as bad as it has been. I got this big piece of steel quite a while back. They were cutting pieces of steel off to put these posts in to hold the building up. And I took it and asked about a piece of it and got it. For this purpose. So I still have two or three old pieces of railroad rail that I've had forever. But this is longer or flatter. Come on now, grip onto it. There it goes. Now that piece is going back. I got one piece of dirty. This one just needs cut in half. Still have tools all over the place. Which is never nothing unusual for me. I'm gonna walk up front here and get a few pieces of this. Get it cut up. Help but turn you guys back around to where I'm working, wouldn't it? If I could get it back in the picture again. I don't know how long the copper tubing coming in is going to last, because my guy that does the construction that I'm getting all this from, they're all going to the new stuff, putting it in. So, but I know I've been getting quite a bit of it from him. Hope Cindy can make it through the night. She's got the toothache. Still working. So, just starting my copper collection all over again so that I could get her medicine. It's better than... One thing I can't do is sit back and let her... I'll do without anything in the world, I can't let her sit back and hurt. I screwed up my ankle about a week ago in here. Stepped on something and turned it. I didn't go to the doctor or nothing. I just kept going until I worked the soreness back out of it. That's all I could do. Keep working. He had a bunch of pipe and stuff with this old water pipe. I took, just brought it home and stacked it on the trailer. One of these days when the trailer gets full enough to my liking, we'll take a load in. But it just ain't been full enough to where I want it to be. I see a lot of guys that just throws a little load on their truck and takes it in. I don't do that. I try to wait until I get more of a load. Well, that's going to make that fun to get off. I hit the brass instead of the copper. Mash that sucker in. Oh well. Yeah, done a good job on that one. That one is a play with later when I can do a little bit more cussing and yelling at it. So, I don't know if anybody else has those days. But, I'll cuss at it later when I take it apart. When I'm not, not taping, not recording. So that way you guys don't have to hear it. Oh, not much. Size piece of copper. Set that one up off the floor. Put this wire over here. I know I ain't gonna get that off because I couldn't get the other one to come off all the way. So, we'll turn it. Set it up here. And then try and hit it. I know, I break it up in short pieces. No way it lays down flat in a bucket. You get more weight in a bucket. didn't want to take my copper in, but had to. One more time. Alright. This one has a sleeve in it. Let's see. Another piece of brass to cuss at. So I can get this sleeve off of here. Hammer coming out at me. I think I got one more piece up there. Two. proper pickup for today. Set it back and work on filling up the bucket again later. Up here, I forgot. I guess I wasn't done with the copper yet. Copper, dirt, and mud in my tea cup. Set the faucet back over there for now. Thought I was done. Where did I put my little pin? So I'm going to have to move down that way to the vise.
can't turn over my papers. Tell it's getting a little better outside. It's not cold out there, chilly, but the neighbors that have been hugging against their wood stove all winter are outside, playing around in the yard. So, I know it's getting warmer. Round and round we go. There's that piece. And it went under the bench. Come back over here. I know that piece of plastic comes out or one way or another. Smaller screwdriver. Started to. Still not all of you. That's got it. Put that clean brass. That's got that part. Now the other stuff they're going to is this quick connect stuff. I gotta figure out how to get it apart. I don't know.
I know how to separate part of it. That's all plastic. Get it broke down into pieces small enough to handle. Never messed with this stuff before, so I'll just have to tinker with it. Ain't got none of my cords out. I was working the other day and stepped on the end of that and it rolled under my foot. And that's how I took and messed my ankle up. Come on, stay up there so I don't have to pick you up off the floor. Get behind that bucket. There it goes. So, the glove now. Ain't gonna worry about that wire jabbing me through my hand. These old DeWalt grinders, they last forever, but the cords on them come apart after a while. About the only flaw I can find in them are the cords cracking and breaking up. Other than that, they'll pretty much last for a long time. Now I've got a bunch of brass laying around again to take apart. So, let's see what's... That's good enough to go. go straight to the bucket. Some of those still have to come apart. Since that's got an O-ring on it. I swear I'm gonna paint this thing bright orange or green, because every time I set it down I can't find it. No ring. That's where I put it up there. Tell me next time if you can't see it. I can't find it. See, 38 minutes. I think that's enough for a short video for today. Throw my floor door so it stays off the wet floor. Put this one up here. Put my gloves in the toolbox where they won't get moisture. That goes back up there. Those can go in there. Keep that disc dry because the garage doesn't actually leak, but it gets condensation on the roof and then it drips down into the garage. So I try to keep my tools either underneath of this or a few on top that I don't worry too much about. And the rest of them, they'll be alright. Half of them were found in the scrap pile anyway. So I'm trying to get better content out and everything. But it's kind of slow. With Cindy working and me running back and forth, she didn't get out of work. We didn't get home until after 1 o'clock this morning. And everything, and I slept in part of the day. So, anyway, I'll try to get you to do some more videos later on. So, good night, take it easy, and I'm going to get off of here.